Assalamu alaikum, dear student. Hope you are well by the grace of Almighty. Welcome to NIEVS Home School. I am Bilal Hussain, assistant teacher of mathematics of National Ideal English Fashion School, Day Shift. Dear student, today our topic is data arrangement. Okay. In this chapter, I will discuss at first about data, types of data, population density, and tally sign. And after finishing this, I will solve CVQ questions. Look, what is data? Data is the number-based information. Suppose 2, 4, 6, 8 are even number. So this type of data, this is called data. Types of data. Generally, types of data, data are two types, organized data and unorganized data. Look, organized data. The data which is arranged in ascending or descending order. This type of data is called organized data. Observe here, at first 2, then 4, then 6, then 8. Okay? So this type of data is called organized data. And this is arranged in smaller together. So this type of data is called organized data. Next, unorganized data. Look, the data which is not arranged in smaller to greater or greater to smaller, this type of data is called unorganized data. Look here, 2, then 10, then 3. Actually, this is not arranged in ascending order or descending order. So, this type of data is called unorganized data. Next, population density. What is population density? Population density is the measurement of people live in an area and its unit is people per square kilometer. Suppose the population of a village is 500 and its area is 10 kilometer. What I told you the density, the people of a village is 500 and its area is 10 kilometer. Then we have to determine the population density. Look, we know the population density's formula. Population density equal to population by area. Here look, population equal to 500, so you put here 500, area is 10 kilometer, right here 10 kilometer, then divide, then you get 50, and unit of population density is people per square kilometer. Okay, if we say what is the formula of area, then you write area equal to population divided by population density. If I say what is the formula of population, then you say population density into area, and unit of population equal to people and unit of area equal to square kilometer. Now I will discuss about tally sign. Listen, if there are four items, then we express like this way. But when there are five items, then we express like this way. That means to represent five, we like this way. When there will be six items, then you write like this way. Four, then five, then six. Hope you understood. Now I will solve the CVQ question. Look, the following data shows the weight of 15 students in one school. 32, 22, 25, 20, 28, 29, 33, 23, 29, 24, 25, 25, 21, 32 and 28. Okay? A number, what is data? We know data is the number based information. Okay? You write, what is data? Data is the number based information. Suppose 2, 4, 6, 8 are even number. Finish. Now, B number. Prepare a table in class interval 5. B number, look. Here is class interval is given. That means, right? Class interval equal to 5. Okay. Highest weight, right? Highest weight equal to, look, 33 kg. The lowest weight, lowest equal to 20 kg. Okay. To make a prefer a table, we have to need at first number of classes. So at first we have to determine the range. We know range equal to highest value or highest weight minus lowest weight plus 1. Okay? That means what I told, highest value or highest weight. Highest weight is 33 and lowest weight is 20. Then you add plus 1. Then you get 13 plus 1. Is equal to 14. Okay, this is the range. Now we determine the number of classes. Look, taking as 5 class interval, number of class will be, right, taking as 5 class interval, number of class will be range divided by class interval, or you write interval. That means range here 14. We divide 14 by class interval equal to 5, right? 5. Now divide 14 by 5. You show the half. 5 to the 10. Now 4. Take point 4. Okay. 0 then 5 8s are 40. This equal to 2.8. That means 2.8 is equivalent of 3. Okay, therefore we see that number of class will be 3. Now we make a distribution table. Distribution table. Okay. Look, class interval. Class interval then tally then number of students. Class interval lowest weight is 20 and we have to take class interval 5. Okay, look, how can we count? Sometimes you confused. Look, you start from 20, your class interval will be 5. How can we count? You start like this way. This is 20, 21, 23, at first you 20, 21, 22, 23, then 24. Okay, this is 24. Then 25 to 29. Similarly, you take class interval 5. Then 30 to 34. I hope you understood. Look, total. Now carefully look. First number is 32. This number where lies? Here is 32. Here lies 32. Then 22. Where? Here. Then 25. Where? Here. Then 20. Where? Here. 28 is in here. 29 is in here. 33 here. Then 23 where? Here. Then 29 here. 24 here. 25 here. Then again 25. Then 21. 21. Then 32, where? Here. Then 28, where? Here. 28. Okay, now count the tally. 5. Then 7. Then 3. In total, 7 plus 3, 10, 10 plus 5. That means 15. Okay, B number question. What is our B number question? B number question. Prepare a table or a distribution table, same. Prepare a table in class interval 5. Okay, this is the required distribution table or table of class interval 5. I hope you understood. Now I will solve C number questions. C number question is draw a histogram using the table of the data. That means to draw a histogram, you need this table. Okay? So you write again. You write again this table. Okay? This is called C. And you write here, we have got from B. We have got from B in this table. Okay? Now we have to draw a histogram using this table. Okay? In C number question, you must be write this. C C we have got from B. Okay, that means in B we have got this table. Now we have to draw a histogram. Now how can look? Let X O X dash be the X axis. Okay, look, X O X dash be the X axis and Y O Y dash equal to Y axis. Right now let X O X dash be the X axis and Y O Y dash be the Y axis and they are intersecting point is 0 or origin. Look, their intersecting point is 0. See the histogram, their intersecting point is 0. Okay, both X O X dash and Y O Y dash, their intersecting point is 0. Okay, now along X axis we take every 2 square of length equal to 1 unit. Along x axis every 2 square of length equal to 1 unit. Okay, this is every 2 square of length equal to 1 unit. Every 2 square of length equal to 1 unit. And along y axis every 5 square of length, every 5 square of length equal to 1 unit. Okay, now along x axis represent the class interval and along y-axis represent the number of students. Number of students. Okay, now we draw a histogram using the above information. Okay, look here, X O X dash, this is X axis, and y o y dash. This is called y axis. 0 to 24, I have given a broken line. That means between 0 to 20, the rest of the number lies on. And look, along x axis represent the class interval, and along x axis represent the number of students. Look, number of students, and I have written here class interval. Okay, look, every 2 square of length equal to 1 unit. Look, 20 to 24, that means here to here, you count here, there is 10 square length, and 25 to 29 here is 10 square length. Similarly, 30 to 34 here is also 10 square length. Look, 20 to 24, how many number of students? 5. So 20 to 24.